afternoon, or good evening. You have just tuned in to the 3 a.m. Download Devotional. I'm your host, David L. March Sr., and we want to welcome you this morning. Hopefully you've had your coffee, and this week is going prosperous for you. Or whatever time you're listening to this, I want to welcome you this morning, this afternoon, or this evening to the 3 a.m. Download Devotional Podcast. Well, I hope you enjoyed this series that we've been on, learning how to see yourself as God sees you. Well, the other day, we talked about number 3 in this series. Learn how to walk in your own shoes. Isn't that phenomenal? That something as simple as that can be so profound and instrumental in your life. Things that you've heard throughout your whole life, God uses to bring and edify you and bring wisdom to you. So, last time we left off again with number 3, learn how to walk in your own shoes. So a quick recap. At the end, I specified to you that your anointing is in your authenticity. Keep it real. Be you. Stop imitating the anointing you see and be a champion with the anointing that's in you. Why? Because the anointing that you have was designed specifically for you by God, our Father, our Creator, our Designer, our Mold Maker. You know, when I talk about the Mold Maker, I think about the potter's wheel. How even on the potter's wheel, which is called life, our everyday life, we're on the potter's wheel, we are constantly being molded by God. So as he's molding us, we won't fit anywhere else on the turning wheel except for wherever he puts us. Isn't that amazing? God is so good. Okay, so number four, the fourth and last one that I know of, unless God wants to speak and give me number 5. Number 4, in order to see yourself as God sees you, you must first listen. Hear the word for yourself. And what I mean by that? Well, in Matthew chapter 11, verse 15, it says this. In the New King James Version, it says, "He who has ears to hear, let him hear." King James says, "He that hath ears to hear, let him hear." The Christian Standard Bible says, "Let anyone who has ears listen." And that's in Matthew chapter 11, verse 15. The NIV says it like this. I don't like using the NIV a lot, but I like the way they said it. "Whoever has ears, let them hear. Anyone with ears to hear should listen and understand." That's the NLT, the New Living Translation. I haven't had my coffee yet. Ooh. That was my bottle of water I was drinking. A little loud there. Sorry. So, in order to see, you must first listen. Okay? Think about it like this. Something goes bump in the night. What's the first thing happens? You hear the bump. Then you get up to look for it. Right? When the two disciples were, Paul and Silas were in the prison, as he was worshiping at midnight, there came a sound. There came a sound. Anytime there's a move of God, it is preceded by a sound. And then you see. You don't believe me? Look, in the beginning of the Bible, in the book of Genesis chapter 1, it said, "In the beginning, God." What does it say a few verses after? And he spoke the word, let there be light. And there was light. When he spoke, that created a sound. And then the visual confirmation of it came. So if you're trying to see yourself as God sees you, listen for his still small voice. God doesn't speak loudly. He wants us to drown out all the noise around us so we can hear his voice. That's why he whispers to us in a still small voice, in a sweet voice, he speaks to us. Why? Because he wants us to willingly listen for his word. And how does that happen? How do we train ourselves to hear his word? Well, here's just a few things to look at. One, God speaks to us in dreams. He speaks to us in visions. He speaks to us through a spoken word from our pastor, from the preachers, through this podcast. He speaks to us through music. He speaks to us in small voices. So I'm going to be doing another podcast on helping you understand to hear that still small voice. But if you go back in the archives of this particular podcast, the 3 a.m. Download Devotional, there's a podcast in there about the still small voice. So I encourage you to go back and listen to that and then come back and listen to this particular podcast of learning how to see yourself as God sees you. You must first listen. Listen carefully, because God speaks to us every single day. And if you give up, if you get up in the morning with your heart and your mind, and that's the first thing that you want to do is communicate with God, then He's going to speak to you and speak to you often. You know, I started this movement. God put something in my spirit about 2:40, and that's 2 hours and 40 minutes. I've heard, if you listen to the podcast before, you've heard me share this information with you, that 2 hours and 40 minutes is your tithing and your time to God every day, which we are required to give Him. Now, if you're steadfast and you're honorable in doing so, you'll be able to hear God's word speaking to you in every turn, leading and directing you and pouring into you and imparting into you wisdom and understanding, because Proverbs tells us, in all thy getting, get understanding, because wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. But with all thy getting, get understanding. You see, many times people ask for wisdom, but they don't get the understanding of the wisdom that they receive, so they abuse the wisdom. Okay? When God speaks to you, He's ordering your steps. And as He's ordering your steps, He's teaching you how to see yourself as He sees you. When you begin to hear, see, the scripture tells us that His sheep knows his voice, and another they will not hear. So as you're learning to see yourself as God sees you, you're learning his voice. And as you're learning his voice, you're learning and becoming the character. Your character is changing to the character that he desires from you. Why does he desire to change your character? Because we're born in sin and shapen in iniquity. We're born with a character within us that thrives, that hungers, that yearns for fleshly things. But when your character is altered and your DNA is altered for the kingdom, your character and your desires become more about kingdom things. Your character becomes more like God's. You understand what I'm saying? Jesus, when he was walking this earth for 33 years, he came bearing the character of God. But he was tempted in all points, just like we are. But he had the strength, he had the willpower to do what needed to be done and carry out his father's business. You know, there was a thing, a big thing a few years ago about WWJD. What would Jesus do? What would Jesus do? He listened. In the Garden of Gethsemane, he listened. When he was on the cross, he listened. As he walked the street, he listened. There was tons of people there that needed healed. But he listened to the direction of the Father, God in heaven, on how to do certain things, where to go, who to heal, do this and do that. God gives us that same direction every morning. And the more that we spend time with him, the more we hear his voice. And the more that we hear his voice, the more that we're able to see ourselves as he does. Let me give you a cheat sheet. We are a royal priesthood. We are a peculiar people. We have been chosen. We have been set apart. God sees us as royalty. God sees us as his children. And we should expect nothing less. Nothing less. Not saying that we have to have an arrogancy about us. But when you recognize who you are, and whose you are, you carry yourself a little bit different. You don't let people run over you like you used to. Why? Because you realize that there's something about you that belongs in the kingdom. There's something about you that is royalty. There's something about you that sets you apart from everybody else. So that makes you special. That makes you unique. That makes you awesome. That makes you spectacular. But in order for that to happen, you must first put down the two-way mirrors. Stop looking at yourself through someone or something else's reflection, referring to the things of your past, things that have happened to you in your past. Two, clean off your spiritual glasses. You, we, I, we gotta stop looking through the spiritual lenses that don't belong to us. Scripture says, if you seek, you will find. If you seek ye first the kingdom of heaven, all of these things will follow after. Your blessing, your breakthrough has a facial recognition. Learning how to see yourself as God sees you has facial recognition. How do you obtain that? By being hot, humble, open, and transparent. Number three, we have to learn how to walk in our own shoes before trying to feel the void or fill the shoes of someone else. Remember, your anointing is in your authenticity. Keep it real. Be you. Stop imitating the anointing you see and be a champion within the anointing within you. You understand? And don't make the choice to go back to where you came from. God has bigger plans for you than what you realize. Wow, this has been a powerful, powerful series. But I want to leave you with this thought. How you see yourself is how you will view God. But you have to change the lens. Your lens is only one-sided. Once you change that lens, flip it, that lens is your perception. That lens is the perception of how you see yourself. Once you change your perception, you change your outcome, you change your view, you change your perspective. Once that happens, you change the outcome of any situation. But it takes a mental, spiritual choice to be able to change that lens from just seeing it one way, which is through your flesh, changing it to see it through the spiritual lenses and not through the two-way mirrors. Wow. I don't know about you, but this series of learning how to see yourself as God sees you, it's been powerful. It's I'm been on powerful.
It. Okay.
Siri has a mind of her own. Oh, wow, it's too early for all that. But again, I pray that this series has helped you, has blessed you, has gave you some kind of direction, or lighted a path for you to be able to see yourself as God sees you. If you still have trouble, I want to encourage you to read Ephesians, the first two chapters. Study those first two chapters in the book of Ephesians and let it bless you. God sees you as royalty, and you have to believe that. Not just for yourself, but those that are connected to you. Because if you take these principles and apply them to your life, God will send somebody else in your life that's having trouble seeing themselves as God sees you. Seeing themselves as God sees them. So take these four principles, apply them to your life, share them with somebody, share this podcast with somebody, and let it bless them too. My time is coming gone. Man, I can't speak this morning. Jiminy Christmas. But before we go, before we sign off and close out this podcast for the day, and this series, I want to say a quick prayer with you, real quick, to be able to speak a blessing over you as you go forth. All right. So right now, let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, we come to you hot, humble, open, and transparent, thanking you, O God, for helping us to see ourselves as you see us, helping us, Father God, to understand whose we are and not just who we are. Father, I pray, Lord, that everyone that's under the sound of my voice, everyone that's listening to this podcast, God, that they are blessed, Lord, that they would be able to apply these four principles to their life, to their spiritual walk with you, so that they can see themselves just as you see them. So they can realize that they are royalty. They are a chosen generation. They are a royal priesthood. Lord, bless them. Keep your hand upon them. Let your face smile upon them. Let your favor go with them, go before them, and go after them. And Lord, we pray this in the marvelous, majestic, and matchless name of Jesus. Thank you once again, Father God, for the wisdom that you have imparted to me to share these four principles to help someone else see themselves just as you see us. God, we pray that this word does not fall on deaf ears, but that it goes around the world, helping others see and understand just who they are. Lord, we thank you once again in advance, and we praise you from a place of victory and not defeat. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, again, that's my time. Thanks for listening. We love you. We love you. And so does Jesus. Have a blessed week.